Welcome back. You're watching On The Spot. It has been hot even off air, and it's continuing to be hot. Such a controversial topic. Polygamy in the church by pastors. Very new. Pastor Solomon Male.
Thank you very much again. And I don't think I miss words by saying that Chimera is off track. He's part of the errant Christians, in quotes, whom we as Christians no longer regard as Christians. Because the Bible is clear, one man, one wife. And when it comes to even Christian leadership, it is even much more than that. Because in 1 Timothy chapter 3, when it talks about it, the integrity of a leader, of a Christian leader, who should be a man of one wife, who should be able to control or to contain, to look after the affairs of his family, his wife, his children. And then Chimera claims to be a pastor. I'm surprised. Then three, Branham, Erad, and we who are scholars of theology, of Christian literature, do not regard him as a true Christian prophet of
but,
these
but
times.
But is it not true also, Pastor Solomon Male, that today even people who are married, one wife and one husband, the family is disintegrating? What causes that?
We have what we call serial monogamists. Serial monogamists. They marry, then they divorce, and they remarry. Those are also unbiblical. Because it's for better, for worse, till death.
So if there are two consenting or five consenting adults who decide to live in a marriage, and they are worshipping God, and they are old enough, is that wrong?
When that is a polygamous marriage. Well, you see, God's grace
Excuse me, just a moment.
When God calls you as you are, if you've been in a polygamous relationship, you come as you are. God will sort it out.
What's the name?
You are not in a polygamous relationship, but then you decide to get into it knowingly what the scripture says, that a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one.
Okay, hold on there. The name of your church is End Times Message Gospel Church.
End Time Message.
Really?
Gospel.
We're nearing the end, aren't
yes,
we?
Yes, look here, Mr. Kamala. I'm coming back to him. Never misquote the scripture or misinterpret it. In Timothy chapter 3, which he quoted, it didn't say to the whole church. It gives only one man who wants to be a bishop or wanted to be a deacon. So it means the early church was polygamous. And not only that, I have proof.
We have a caller. Just hold on.
Mr. Kamara,
we have a caller.
Let me make a point.
I'm picking world history because it looks like, okay, world history. We have a call online. Timothy from Etiana. Hello?
Yes.
Emmanuel from Etiana, what's your point?
Thank you very much. I'm watching you live. If a man calling himself a pastor would be right, but he's lacking some actually spiritual guidance. I support Pastor Male. I had a sister who misread the Bible. He didn't go to school. Where there is a scripture which says that we shall be stepping on the poisonous snakes and what have you. She went and stepped on it. And eventually she died. She misinterpreted the scripture.
In conclusion, excuse me. Yes.
There is another scripture which talks about praying and we the mountains. It doesn't mean that you are going to pray and you break the mountain, the physical mountain that you see.
You must have
a spiritual interpretation of it, that the mountain that we are talking about could be a problem that you are facing. You pray and it can go away.
Okay.
So similarly, Pastor is interpreting it like that way.
Okay, I have another call online. I have Isaac who is calling from Kawempe. Isaac?
Yes, please. Good evening.
Good evening, Isaac.
This is Isaac Akaba from Kawempe.
Mm-hmm.
I'm really so disappointed. Pastor Chimera, really? You're even saying, look at our faces in the cathedral. We are too disappointed. Bye.
Okay. He's lost for words. He's very disappointed in you, Pastor Patrick. Chimera.
Can I come in?
I was making my point.
Both questions
he was making his point.
I was making my point. Chimera,
I'll give you time. I'm giving you equal time.
sums up and says that the church in the West is accepting homosexuality and is accepting divorce and remarriage, but then fighting polygamy. I'm on record. You hosted me on this very show.
Mr. Kamara, I was dealing with homosexuality. Malay has taken a lot
I'm
of
on record
time.
I'm fighting homosexuality. Why? And
the problem with the pastor.
No, it's fine.
Let us give each other time.
Let him talk.
Okay.
It's part, okay. There's part of the body of Christ that has chosen to take the right path, and I'm for that. We are fighting each and every evil in the church, even
excuse
amongst
me,
pastors.
Mr. Kamara, I'm coming
and there
back.
Is part
we want
that
to call by the Bible. That's
body
not
of
the
Christ
Bible.
That have decided here to go contrary to what the Bible teaches.
Let me go to the people. Let me go to the people.
Give me two men of God.
No. I cannot understand this now.
Let's just take it to the people.
The voice of the people can be the voice of God sometimes. We have Joachim from Zambia.
Yes, Patrick.
Yes, sir.
How are you doing?
I'm fine, thank you.
Hey, I'm just wondering where that pastor, I don't know, pastor who?
Pastor Kimera.
Who is saying that even God was polygamous? I don't know where he's getting that Bible. Is the Bible different from ours? So I'm just listening, Pastor Malay is doing a good work. I appreciate it.
And we have another caller from Untinda. Thank you very much.
Good evening.
Yes, sir.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
First of all, I'm so disappointed with NTV for hosting such kind of man on a national television.
Mm. He has his views.
These are wrong pastors that they were teaching in the Bible who come preaching wrong things. But speaking such an old man, a parent of some kids out there, here on the national television, preaching polygamy, that it's right, and he misquotes the Bible entirely. These people deserve to be hanged.
Excuse me.
Not stop.
Okay.
This kind of thing to the public. Thank you.
Your language is very hard.
Excuse me.
We have a last caller, Martha from Munyonyo.
Yes, hello.
Yes, Martha. Hello? Okay, the line, Martha, is not very clear, and I apologize for that. Pastor Kimera.
I'm coming back. I have heard them.
People are disappointed.
Let me tell you.
They can't believe this.
Let me tell you, Satan is not people. Normally, Satan is fighting the truth. This is the truth. Because in the last days, even if you look in Isaiah chapter 4, it says, seven women will hold to one man, we shall be called by your name. Not only that, in the early church, I give you a chance to explain. You know, people fear when the scripture are read. He hasn't read the scripture. Only one scripture in Genesis.
I know.
No, I have given scriptures and scriptures.
Do you know tonight, you have made many, many Christians in this country
let them cry, shed tears
of what you're saying.
Because for one reason, they are breaking the Bible and the history. And the Bible is very clear that God is not the author of this confusion we see. In fact, it says in the last days, men will prohibit marriage.
So you're saying we should not even be referring to the Bible?
No, I'm referring to the Bible. The Bible is true. I have quoted in the New Testament. The New Testament is saying, it speaks of a man.
Let me look back into the history of you, the man. You say your father was married to six wives. Yeah. Your grandfather was married to nine wives.
Mr. Kamala.
And that's a pattern you are following.
Mr. Kamala.
Isn't it? Yes.
I want you to understand me.
It is a tradition.
My father, even your grand and grand were polygamous. And you can't stop that. It's a white man's idea which has caused all the trouble we see today. Our children to be prostitutes on the streets. And the same thing happening today, taking our children to be homosexuals.
So
rejecting the right order of God, God has said, let them marry. According to 1 Corinthians chapter 7, Paul says...
So, Pastor Kimera, you've come to help and stop all this kind of...
When you look in Corinthians chapter 7, verse 28, it speaks very clear that if a man marries, doesn't commit sin, and a virgin or a woman who is free, marries, is not committing sin. But if a married woman is touched by any other man, is wrong. And yet we see today what is happening in the world. Children are born without fathers, and we see illegitimate children. The world is going to be cursed by God.
So how many wives do you have?
Many. I told you the other day. I have many wives.
And you're a pastor.
Of course.
And you stand at the pulpit.
David was a great pastor. He written more than I do. And Solomon.
Many will tell you
together,
that you
look
are...
Here, look here. Solomon, David, Abraham, and Moses had two wives. Yet was a great prophet. Met God face to face. Pastor, and all, look here.
Hold on to your point. Mm. Pastor Solomon, when you hear a man like him.
I'm a simple pastor. I've never met God like that.
And you're in the business of saving souls. What plan do you have for him?
I've been married for the last 24 years. I'm one wife with three children. I'm a marriage counselor. I counsel those who are intending to get married and those who are married with problems. And I wish I knew Chimera before the confusion that he's in. Two, he's citing these patriarchs, the Abrahams, the Moseses, the Solomons. They all had problems the moment they engaged in extramarital affairs. And probably, before we even go far, let me just highlight a few of the challenges of getting involved in extramarital relationships, which God saw. And that is why he created one man, one wife in Genesis chapter 2. One, there's a high incidence of contracting sexually transmitted diseases. HIV is already in our doorstep.
Mr. Kamara, sometimes I want to jump
two.
When he's speaking.
You don't have two because he gave you time.
Don't look at shout. Sometimes I wonder.
Okay, this is my Chimera. Court. Can I control this?
Okay. Because
yes,
he's saying something which is not right.
Please. Chimera, be disciplined.
And we are running out of time.
And I don't think you're a pastor when you behave like that. Now, two. You are not already.
We are in the debate.
There is a lot of witchcraft in marriages which are polygamous. And that's why many women go to witch doctors. And some have even gone to pastors and they've defrauded them. Others have even been sexually taken advantage of by witch doctors.
You're concluding in 30 seconds.
I'm saying to him, Malay,
yes,
this should go on the record.
30 seconds.
What is happening in the world today? And people will recall me one day that the man was there, we laughed at him and mocked him. He was the answer to the problem of the social world. Because we can cut the disease and all signs social diseases in just of nothing if polygamy is permitted and there is law to prohibit any man to touch. If you look at Marie, he's telling you 24 years with one wife, but he has several. These pastors, I know them for 30 years. They have children and women, mistresses. They're hiding them. They show you one woman. I'm on the record. All these pastors, I know them for 30 years. We have been together. I know them and I know their mistresses. Why can't they come out in truth? Wait a minute. And tell the world that we are polygamous rather than to say monogamous. Yet hide children and suffer in such a way.
He has made an allegation and your concluding remark.
Let him cite any woman whom he accuses me of having. He's a liar.
Thank you very much.
Finally, I want to tell all the people, this is a person who's confused and wants to confuse. Wallace Soyinka wrote in his book, The Road, that if the madness of an entire nation disturbs a solitary mind,
it's not enough to say the man is mad.
He is not mad. He knows what he's doing. He's just a confused confuser, confused by Branham.
I love
the too many books he has read have actually.
And the Ugandan is the truth.
We are ending on one man, one wife.
You go on the net and find out.
If the madness of an entire nation disturbs a solitary mind, it is not enough to say the man is mad.
Let the people go and find out by themselves.
And that brings us to the end of tonight's show. Join us again next week when we bring you yet another edition of On the Spot. I'm your host, Patrick Amara. Good night and God bless.
May God bless you too.